Guys, let's talk about a big shakeup in Oregon and frankly, national politics now. Representative Peter DeFazio, the longest serving member of the House from Oregon, is retiring after 35 years. Here's part of his press conference today.
You know, I need a little more time for myself, for my health and well-being, for my wife, my family, and for the things I love in Oregon. So with that, today I am announcing that I will not run again for re-election. My district is, thanks to the legislature, now 5 or 6 points better for a Democrat. Finally, I have a district that another Democrat can win. It's no longer a Republican district. And I fully expect to endorse and work hard for the Democratic nominee and keep that seat in the Democratic column.
Now, DeFazio is the chair of the House Transportation Committee, so he's become a pretty prominent member of Congress. He's also represented Southwest Oregon, including Eugene and Roseburg, since 1987. So that in mind, let's take a trip into the KGW vault and look at what he did during his first term in Congress.
Peter DeFazio, the only freshman in the Northwest delegation, spent much of the 100th Congress scrambling to catch up to his senior colleagues. Compared to other newcomers, he had something of a head start, having once been a Capitol Hill aide to his flamboyant predecessor, Jim Weaver. Where DeFazio differs from Weaver is his instinct for playing the political game from the inside. That's why the Northwest House delegation chose DeFazio for the job of fending off White House attacks on the BPA. DeFazio was also outspoken against the administration's Persian Gulf naval operation and aid to the Nicaraguan Contras.
My position is not a penny, not ever, not an aspirin, nothing for the Contras.
All right, good to know. That was a bit of a blast from the past there. I also want to play something a little more recent. It's a video DeFazio posted on Twitter last year when a lot of people were worried, remember this, about mailboxes being removed by the Postal Service ahead of the election with all the mail-in voting. Let's play that.
They're not getting this one.
That video just tickles me. All right, no word on if those mailboxes were spared. I think we're confident that he's unchained himself, though. So now the question is, who is going to run to replace DeFazio? Well, he said today he's not choosing a successor, but you heard he'll support whoever gets the Democratic nomination. And you also heard him say earlier that his district is now more favorable for a Democrat to win. And that's thanks to this year's redistricting process, which was super smooth, as we all know. According to 538, Oregon's old 4th district was pretty much a toss-up based on current partisan divisions. DeFazio, of course, won re-election in 2020, but with less than 52% of the vote. Now, the new district includes fewer rural areas, which makes it more favorable for Democrats. And that could be a problem for Republican Alex Scarletos, who is running for that seat after losing to DeFazio last year. Scarletos, if you don't remember, helped stop a terror attack on a train to Paris in 2015. And he's been trying to get into politics since about that time, for the last few years. On the Democratic side, Oregon Labor Commissioner Val Hoyle just announced that she is running to fill DeFazio's seat. Hoyle was previously the state House Majority Leader representing the Eugene area.